Jim, you're getting new information from your sources about John Bolton's departure.
That's right. Well, President Trump is searching for a new national security advisor this evening after he abruptly announced John Bolton had been fired. In a tweet earlier today, the president gave Bolton the boot after the two men had clashed over key foreign policy decisions, including Mr. Trump's scrapped plan to invite the Taliban to Camp David for peace talks. I'm told the president was upset that Bolton had tried to create the impression that Vice President Mike Pence was opposed to those Camp David talks as well. But as one top administration official insisted earlier today, the president's national security team is not a mess, despite an obvious cleanup job. For now, former National Security Advisor John Bolton, it was an unceremonious firing by tweet. Standing outside the West Wing just hours before he was scheduled to join Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin to answer questions from reporters, Bolton was suddenly gone, with his former administration rivals.
I'm never surprised.
All smiles.
The president's entitled to the staff that he wants. At any moment, this is a staff person who works directly for the President of the United States, and he should have people that he trusts and values and whose efforts and judgments benefit him in delivering American foreign policy.
White House insists Bolton was fired, with the president announcing in a tweet, "I informed John Bolton last night that his services are no longer needed at the White House. I disagreed strongly with many of his suggestions, as did others in the administration, and therefore I asked John for his resignation, which was given to me this morning. I thank John very much for his service. I will be naming a new national security advisor next week." But Bolton essentially tweeted, "That's not true," claiming, "I offered to resign last night," and President Trump said, "Let's talk about it tomorrow." Despite the fact that Mr. Trump has now gone through three national security advisors, administration officials say there's no insecurity when it comes to the president's foreign policy team.
Is this national security team a mess?
Absolutely not. That's the most ridiculous question I've ever heard of. Let me just say, the national security team, which is what you asked, consists of the National Security Advisor, the Secretary of Defense, the Secretary of State, myself, the Chief of Staff, and many others.
Can you disagree with the President?
Of course.
Sources tell CNN Bolton had clashed with the President over a number of critical issues, including Mr. Trump's scrap plan to invite leaders of the Taliban to Camp David just days before September 11th. President and Vice President Mike Pence believed Bolton's team was leaking stories that top administration officials were questioning the idea of a Taliban meeting.
I think the view that there's some public discussions about Bolton being on the other side of meeting with the Taliban probably was a bridge too far. I don't know what happened there.
A foreign policy hawk, Bolton also disliked the idea of sitting down with North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un. Aides say Bolton's contrasting views and outspoken style had irritated the president for months.
He has strong views on things, but that's okay. I actually temper John, which is pretty amazing, isn't it?
Bolton also found himself at odds with Pompeo, who's much more willing to tout the president's foreign policy views.
I know everyone's talked about this for an awfully long time. There were definitely places that Ambassador and I, Bolton and I, had different views.
With Bolton out of the way, the administration is sounding much more open to the idea of Mr. Trump sitting down with Iran's president at the upcoming United Nations General Assembly.
The president has made clear he's happy to take a meeting with no preconditions, but we are maintaining the maximum pressure campaign.
Now, as we just mentioned a few moments ago, the former National Security Advisor John Bolton said in a tweet that he offered his resignation yesterday evening. But if we could put this up on screen, this is John Bolton's resignation letter to the White House. It is dated today, and according to a senior White House official, the president asked for and received that letter of resignation from the National Security Advisor. As one source close to the White House put it, this may be the least surprising firing from the Trump White House as of yet. As one top White House official put it to me earlier today, Wolf, this was a long time in coming.
Wolf. And Bolton in his letter simply says, "Dear Mr. President, I hereby resign effective immediately as Assistant to the President for National Security Affairs. Thank you for having afforded me this opportunity to serve our country. Sincerely, John R. Bolton." Jim, not much there from John Bolton.
That's right, Wolf. You know, this was somebody who clashed with top administration officials, including the president, on a number of occasions on a whole range of subjects. There was no mystery as to where John Bolton stood on Iran, on North Korea, on just about everything under the sun. But he was a man of few words in that resignation letter, Wolf.
Jim Acosta at the White House, thank you very much. Let's get some more on the president's firing of his national security advisor. Our national security reporter, Kylie Atwood, is joining us. Our CNN special correspondent, Jamie Gangel, is with us as well. Kylie, the White House suspected Bolton was actually responsible for leaks, particularly when he strongly disagreed with the president. What are you learning?
That's right. So we are learning today that the straw that broke the camel's back here was National Security Advisor John Bolton disagreeing with the president's decision to invite the Taliban here to the U.S., to U.S. soil, to Camp David to have meetings. National Security Advisor John Bolton didn't think it was a good idea and voiced his disagreement. Reporters then found out about that disagreement, and we have reported on it. But that is not the only policy issue that President Trump disagreed with Bolton on. There's also North Korea. Bolton thought that the Trump administration should be more muscular in its approach, not sit down with those North Korean officials. Iran, similar thing. Bolton thought that a strike against Iran should have happened, but President Trump canceled that strike hours before it was supposed to happen. So these tensions have been bubbling for quite some time, and there is a very, very far distance between these two when it comes to foreign policy. Someone close to Bolton describing the two to me today as a round hole and a square peg from the beginning.
Yeah, it certainly was complicated. Jamie, this relationship between the president and Bolton, you know, I never understood it to begin with, given their very public disagreements on U.S. troops overseas, war overseas. They clashed in policy, certainly clashed in personality. They even clashed as far as facial hair is concerned. His exit, though, it was not unexpected.
No, not at all. For anyone who missed it, Donald Trump never liked John Bolton's mustache, but that was the least of their problems. Look, these two men not only clashed, but behind the scenes, I am told by sources very close to the situation, John Bolton was not supporting the president. A couple of weeks ago in late August, he was supposed to go on the Sunday talk shows. He did not go on. And my source says that it was because he said he couldn't support the president's position. When Trump found out about it, that was yet another blow in the relationship. But I think overall, all of these problems, friends of John Bolton will tell you he's a bull in a china shop. They were surprised he lasted as long as he did, Wolf.
Yeah, I was surprised as well. You know, Kylie, Bolton was scheduled to appear at a White House press briefing with the Secretary of State, the Secretary of the Treasury, just 90 minutes before he was fired. That's when the White House put out the announcement. This was rather awkward.
That's right. So these departures from the Trump administration are never very ceremonious. We have seen President Trump fire members of his national security team, former Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, via tweet before. So this is not necessarily shocking news. But instead of John Bolton showing up there in the briefing room alongside the other members of Trump's cabinet, it was Secretary of State Mike Pompeo defending President Trump's decision to fire John Bolton, saying that the president is entitled to have the team that he chooses.
You know, Jamie, Bolton was growing increasingly reluctant, as you point out, to go on television and defend some of the president's policies. What more are you learning about the tension between these two men?
Well, just as one example, a group from Congress had gone up earlier this year to discuss and try to convince President Trump not to withdraw from Syria. The president stepped out of the room at one point to take a call, and Bolton was reported to have rolled his eyes and said, "Welcome to my world." These kinds of stories were building up, but I think at the end of the day, one of the things we're going to find out very quickly is John Bolton is telling reporters that he is going to explain more in due course. He is not going quietly. So I think we're going to find out more of the details from his point of view. But it was it just had become untenable between the two men.
I suspect we'll be hearing a lot more from him in the coming days and weeks. He used to be a Fox News contributor before joining the White House, so he might be going back there or someplace else. All right, Jamie and Kylie, guys, thanks very much. Let's get some more on all of this. Joining us now, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, Democratic Congressman Adam Schiff of California. Mr. Chairman, thanks very much for coming in.
Good to be with you.
You were never a big fan of John Bolton, so are you happy the president got rid of him?
Well, I am until we find out who comes next, because the story of this administration is one of going from bad to worse. But he was always a poor fit for a national security advisor, someone who ideally has the judgment and temperament to bring people together to be an honest broker for the president, to allow the president to hear conflicting points of view and help the president along to a decision. In Pompeo's statement that the president is entitled to someone he values and trusts, he was basically saying the president didn't value Bolton, didn't trust Bolton. Ironically, though, on a couple key issues, this failed idea for a summit at Camp David and these colossal failures with North Korea, Bolton was right. That kind of unprepared, high-stakes summitry, that reality TV kind of diplomacy isn't going to work with North Korea. It didn't work with the Taliban. It hasn't worked with the Iranians. And I think it's been a mistake.